Hi guys, my name is Freddy, and in this video I will show you step by step how you can create an amazing header for your website using Elementor Pro. Let me show you what we will cover in this tutorial. We will create a header from scratch with a logo and a navigation menu. We will style the background in a way that will be fully or partly transparent. Then we will optimize the header for all devices and make it sticky so when you scroll, the header sticks on the top of the page. We will also add social icons and optimize those for all devices. Then I will show you how you can change the background color, link and icon colors, and the logo when you scroll so you get something like this. I will also show you how you can hide social icons on a mobile. After that, we will create a top header with social icons and a call to action and style it in a way that it will not stick with the main part of the header. Also here we can optimize the top header by adjusting the margin and padding pixel by pixel until we think it's perfect. We will decide on which pages the header should appear, duplicate the complete header and remove the transparency so we can apply the second header to certain pages in our website that do not need a transparent header on their page. In the end, I will show you how you can export your beautiful header so you can use it over and over again on your or your client's Elementor Pro websites. If you already have a header and you want to go directly to the sticky header part, you can go to the timestamps in the description, and when you click on one of those timestamps, you go directly to that part of the tutorial. And if I go too fast for you, you can slow down the video by clicking here and change the speed of the video. I hope you like what you're seeing so far. If you do so, please like this video and feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress, Elementor, Divi, affiliate marketing and e-commerce related tutorials. And then I would like to say, let's get started. So what I have over here is my test domain with Elementor installed, a few pages like this. And I use the Hello theme. So if I click on appearance themes, I use the Hello theme, which is actually an empty theme. So we're going to do everything with Elementor Pro. If you have that, it's great. You can install it. If you don't have it, you can go to ferdycorp.com/Elementor. This is an affiliate link. So when you buy it through my link, you don't pay more, but I get a commission. So thank you for that. Then we go to pricing and you have the same package for one website, three websites or 1,000 websites. And one is $49, second one $99, the third one $199. If you pay $199 per year for 1,000 websites, that will be around 20 cents per website. If you go for this package, you pay $275 per month per website. If you go for this one, you pay less than $5 per month for a website. And the great thing is what we're going to make with this header, we can duplicate it, save it, import it to other websites. So if you have a lot of websites with Elementor Pro, you can save a lot of time and import the thing we're going to create in this video. So you can buy it over here and then you can download it. I have it already. So what I will do, I will go to plugins, click on add new, click on upload a plugin, choose a file, and then I go to my downloads. I search for Elementor Pro. And there it is, the most recent version. I click on open. And then I click on install now. Awesome. I can activate it over here. And then I can activate the license over here by clicking on connect and activate. I log in with the same details I entered at elementor.com. I click on login. And I can select my license, activate it. And now I've installed and activated Elementor Pro on my website. Awesome. So what I want to do, if I take a look at the website, this is how it looks. Not that beautiful. We're going to make it look so much better. So I go to the backend. Then I go to templates, theme builder. And this is the old theme builder. We want to use the new theme builder. So we click over here. Then you see this area. We can create something over here. We can create a header, a footer, single post, single page. And I want to create a header for the whole website. So I click on the plus over here. And then we can build it from a pre-made template, a block, but I want to start from scratch. So I close this and then I click on the plus over here. We will create a section with two columns. So I click over here and here we see that at the left, I want to have my logo and at the right, I want to have my menu. So what I want to do, I want to make use of a transparent menu. So you can see the pages beneath the menu. So I want to have a white logo and I want to have white links in my navigation menu. And when I start to scroll, I want to have a white background and a colored logo and a colored menu. So that's what we're going to do. And we're going to do so much more. It's going to be amazing. And you're going to learn a lot if you're not familiar with how to do this. So I go over here to all the elements and I drag this image over here. I choose an image by clicking here, and I have my media library already filled up with images. So you can upload a file from your computer. And in my case, I grab my white logo. Make sure you have a logo in white and in color, and it needs to be the same size. So first I want to upload the white logo or insert it. So I click on insert media, and now we don't see it because it is white. So what I want to do, I want to hover over here, click on the section, and then I go to the style of the section, and I want to create a background. So I add background type, I click on classic. I choose a color, and that color will be black, but then I drag the transparency to the left so you can see through it. And what I also want to do over here, I see three areas. I want to make it four by enabling the editing handles. So I click over here, the three lines, I go to the user preferences and I turn on editing handles. Awesome. I click over here. So I go to the settings of the image and I want to change the image size to 300. So WordPress will load a smaller image. Then I want to align it to the left and I want to have a link to the homepage. So at link, I select a custom URL and it's just a forward slash. So you go to your current domain. Then I go to the style and here we can change the width of the website in percentage or in pixels. I like to make things pixel perfect. So I say 200 pixels. We can change the max width, the height, but right now I'm happy with it. What I can do, I can publish it. So if I click here, I will publish this and now I can set the publishing settings. So I can add conditions. So for instance, I can say I only want to show this on a certain page. So I go to a singular page and then I select the contact page. But I want to show it on the whole website. So I click on add conditions, entire site. Save and close. So far, so good. And then I want to add the navigation area. So I click over here. So I go back to all the elements and I drag the navigation menu over here and we can adjust it. So I want to do that. I want to bring this to the right. First, I can select a menu. I have one menu and it's over here. If you want to create a menu, you can go to your website, click on the customize settings, go to menus. You can create a new menu. And when you've created it, you can click on it and you can add new items like new pages, type it over here and then edit. And then over here, you can select that menu. Well, the layout is horizontal, so it's from the left to the right. I want to align it to the right. And when I hover over here, you see an underline. We can change that to overline. You can even have something like this text and then it becomes bigger or it shrinks. I like to keep it simple. So I say none. So when I hover over it, you see nothing. When I hover over it, I want to change the color. I will do that later. So no pointer. Submenu indicator. Classic, you can change it. The submenu indicator, that's this arrow over here. I like it. So I click on update. And if I want to take a look at the results, I click on this eye over here and then on preview. What I see, I don't know why it's not seeing this icon. So right now I'm like, you know what? I don't want to use it. They will probably fix it soon. So now it's gone. When a visitor wants to go to services, he will see, oh, there are a few services. Mail modeling, for instance. Yes, that's also something I do. You know, when I cannot get any film projects, I do mail modeling and I make a lot of money with it. Just showing my beautiful face and stuff. Whatever. So let's continue. I click over here. So I go to the settings of the navigation menu. And there are three areas: content. So about the content of this area. Then there's the styling. We can change the colors and stuff. We'll do that in a minute. Before we will do that, we go to the mobile dropdown. The breakpoint, when you make the website smaller, when should it become a hamburger menu like that? Well, the breakpoint is right here. And I think that is perfect. So I leave it as it is. And the submenu, let me go to a tablet view. When I click over here, it looks like this. I don't like it. I want the submenu to be full width. So when I click here, it's over the full width of this area. and I want to align it to the center. So the text goes to the center and the toggle button is a hamburger or nothing. Well, I want it to be a hamburger. I want to have the alignment of the hamburger at the right. And then I go to the style and I want to go back to the normal screen. By the way, if you go to the mobile, it looks like that. Looks a little bit weird. So what I want to do, I want to go to the desktop and over here at the settings, I want to make the column width 50%, and this column width, this column also 50%. And then when I go to the tablet, it looks okay. When I go to the mobile, I need to do that again. So I click on the column over here, 50, and the column below also 50. Nice. I go back to the normal screen and I go to the style of this menu. Style. Okay. I can change the typography. So I click over here. I can make this a different font. So for instance, Railway, I like that one, Railway. And there are so many fonts you can choose. I love that. We can change the size until you're satisfied. Well, I think this looks great. And I want to change the transformation or transform it to uppercase. And then I think, you know what, it's a little bit big. This is perfect. 16. We can change the weight to really bold or really thin. And I like it the way it is. So I say default. Make it a bit bigger. Yeah. Okay. I'm happy with how things look. And I want to change the color. Again, we're going to make everything white because we're going to have a darker background. So I want to change the color to white. And then there's the horizontal padding. You can create more space. If you don't like it, just remove it and it will go back to the default settings. Also here, when you see this, you can change it for every device. But I do not do that over here. Space between. Bring it back. Then there's the drop down. And what I would like to do, I would like to go to the settings, go to the layout, go to the height of the setting, and I say minimum height. Well, it's too much, of course. I can change this to 80. And then I can go down until I'm satisfied. I think 70 is perfect. So when I have that, I see over here that this white area starts over here, or the submenu. I want to increase that a little bit. So what I can do, I can scroll down. If I go to the navigation menu to style, then I go close this, go to the drop down area all the way down. And there's the distance. And if I increase it, for instance, 10, look at this. Now it seems to align perfectly. So I keep it at 10 or maybe 11. Yes, perfect. So that's what you can do. Let's go back to the top of the drop down. How do I want this to look? Well, I want to use the colors in my website. So the text color, it's okay. But when I hover over it, so over here, the tab hover, I can choose a different background. So I choose a primary color. I created a few colors, global colors, and I will use them over here. Look at that. If you want to know a lot of basic stuff about Elementor, I have a tutorial about it. You can find it over here or in the description. And there I'll talk about all these things like global colors and stuff. So this is what I like. What I also want to do, I want to make this uppercases. So how can I do that over here at typography? Again, Railway, uppercase. Yeah, I think it looks great. Awesome. What I see is that this is not exactly in the center vertically. So I can edit the column. Then I can go to vertical alignment, middle. And what I also want to do, the widget space, bring it to 0. Also here, select the column. And if you cannot select the column, there's also the navigator. We're going to work now and then with the navigator. Here you see the section that is this area, blue line, has two columns. So here, column 1, column 2. And in those columns, I have an image and a navigation menu. So if I click on the column, I go to the column settings over here. If I click on the second column, I can go to this area. So if I cannot select it because this is in front of it, and I can select it over here using the navigator. And then I go to the layout. And also here I say vertical alignment, middle, horizontal alignment at the end. Here I say 0 and I go to the first column and the horizontal alignment, I bring it to the start. So it goes to the left. So let's take a look. If I click on update and I click on the eye, I see the results over here. And when I change something over here, for instance, I go to the section and I change the color to something else and I update it, it will be automatically refreshed over here. So in that way, you can change something over here and you can see the result here immediately. Or you can click over here, but I suggest you always take a look over here because some things will not be shown over here and they will be shown over here. So let me bring this back to a little bit more transparent. And what I want to do now, I want to add a new area over here so we can see the result better. Right now, I cannot scroll, for instance, and I want to scroll. So what I want to do, I want to create a new section by clicking on the plus, one area. And then over here at height, I say minimum height. Let's make it 1,000. Then I go to the style and I want to have a gradient. The first color is a global color, my primary color. And the second one is a secondary color. Then I click over here. So I go to all the elements and I drag a heading over here. I bring it to the center. I go to the style. I make the color white. Typography, make it a bit bigger. And then I call this reference. So I update it. I see the result immediately. And if I scroll down, I see the reference. So I see I'm scrolling down. It's easier than when you don't see this. So that's what I want to have. What I want to do now, I want this area, everything below this menu, I want it to be beneath this menu, beneath this header. How can we do that? Well, I said over here in the section that the height is 70 pixels. So what I want to do, I go to advanced of the section and then I uncheck this. And at the bottom, I want to have a minus margin. So if I would say 70, you see there are 70 pixels, there are 70 pixels, but I want to have minus 70. So this area will be pushed below the header. So if I do minus, it looks awesome, except for one thing, I don't see this area anymore. How come? Because of the Z index. So over here, it seems to be layers. So what I can say, this is layer 10. So it will be in front of everything below that. So when you say 10 or 100 or even 1, it is enough to show this area. So if I update it, it looks like that. So far, so good. A nice clean menu. But what I also can do, I can make it stick. So I select the section, I go to advanced, and then there's a tab called motion effects. And I can turn on the sticky to the top. And now if I scroll down, it sticks with us. That's how easy it is. I can also say I want to show this on the desktop and a tablet, but not on the mobile. So if I close this, it will not be shown on a mobile. It will not stick on a mobile. Okay, what I want to do, check the result, play around, scroll a few times up and down just to be satisfied and think, wow, I'm creating something so beautiful. And then we can go back. And what I can do now, I want to have one more area over here. So I click over here and I search for social. I drag social icons over here below, but I want to next to each other. How can I do that? Well, I click over here on the navigation element and I go to advanced. I close this and then I scroll down to positioning and I change the positioning from default to inline. Okay. I do the same over here. Click over here, go to advanced, scroll down to positioning and I change the width to inline. Awesome. What I want to know, I click over here and I want to change the percentage. Right now is 50-50. I want to change it to 30. 70. Why? Because then this will be next to each other. Update. Okay. One thing, it looks ugly in my opinion. So I want this to be the same style as the whole menu. How can I do that? I click over here. I go to the content area of the social icons. And first I want to remove Twitter. I don't have Twitter. I want to add an item. And I click on the icon and I call this one Instagram. That's the real deal these days. Then I want to have my link. So let me see. Instagram. Pretty corpus hook. Awesome. I copy it. And then I paste it over here. So when people click over here, they go to my Instagram. Okay. Shape rounded, columns automated. And I want to align it to the right. Then I go to the style and I can use the colors of Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram, but I want to use custom colors. The primary color, I want it to be transparent. So the lower bar, I drag it totally to the left. And the secondary color, I want it to be white. And that's the case already. So I like it. The size, I click on the arrow up so I can decide how big I want it to be. And that's okay. Then we can take a look at padding, spacing. So I can increase the spacing if I want to. And what I like is here's this amount of space. I want to have that also. So I click over here. I go to advanced. Uncheck the margin. And at the left, I increase the area a little bit. Then I go back to the style. And I want it that when people hover over it, something changes. So how can I do that? I go to the icon hover. I can change the color. Or I can have a hover animation. Or both. I want it to grow. Like that. So I update it and we have a sticky header with our menu and with these icons. And if I go over here, this looks nice in my opinion, exactly at this line. So I don't see this hover yet. So what I can do, I can go to the area over here, go to style. And when I hover over it, I want to select a color. So right now you see there's a color. I can do the same. With active, that means if I update it and I would go to the blog page, it will stay red. So that's what you can do. And while I'm working on the menu, I want this to be a little bit thicker. So I go to the typography and at weight, I say 600, maybe 5. Yes. And then of course I want to change the color of the active area to maybe a little bit less gray or less than white. Copy this code, go to hover, paste it. So when I hover over it, it becomes a little bit darker. Not too much, just enough. Update. How does it look now with this area on a smartphone or on a tablet? So far, so good. And I don't like this. So what I can do, I can click over here. I go to advanced of the social media icons. I scroll down and at responsive, I say, hide this on the mobile. So I update it. Looks good. I make it smaller. I make it even smaller. And now it is gone. I only see this area and this area. Then I want to take a look at the tablet version. I see the color over here and I don't like the color. So I go to the style. I scroll down to the toggle button and the background color. I want it to be transparent, nothing. The color, I want it to be white. And if I want to, I can have a border. So I say 1. And when I hover over it, I can change the colors, the background color to the global color, this one. So like that, if I want to. Update. So again, the menu with the social icons, if I make it smaller, you see the hamburger. If I click on it, it looks like that. And if I make it even smaller, it looks like that. So I want to take a look at this area, make it a little bit bigger. So if I click over here, what I can do, I can go to the drop-down area. I can change these colors if I want to. And then over here, the vertical padding, I can increase it until I'm satisfied. I can also have a border between those areas, a solid line, change the color to orange make it thicker so you can see it, or like this, but I prefer not to use it. I increase it a bit more and then automatically it will be done for the mobile version. And also here I can change the distance. So something like this. Update. A little bit of trial and error if I make it smaller. Awesome if I make it even smaller. Yeah, I should decrease it a bit. But this is what I meant with playing around. Update. Yeah, make it smaller. Okay. So far, so good. But what I want to do now, I want this to become a colored logo and I want this to become a dark text and this a white background when I scroll. So we have a CSS for that. And let me show you how it works. First, I want to make this dark and background white. In order to do that, go to ferdycorp.com, hit enter. Then go to tutorials, Elementor Pro. And then below, I have a few codes, sticky header background and link colors. If you copy this code, let me explain it to you. When you start scrolling over here, a certain CSS code will be created by Elementor. The code is called Elementor Sticky Effects. So what I can say when this is applied from this moment on, when I scroll, then I can say the background should be white. So if it is not applied right now, it is this color. And when I start scrolling, that code will be activated. And if that code says the background should be white of the header, then it becomes white. Then over here, it says the same thing. When it starts to scroll with this Elementor effect, all the links and all the icons should get the color white. This is a color code. This is black actually. So I can copy this code. I can go to Elementor. Go to the desktop. Then I go to the, let me see. I go to the section, this section over here, advanced, custom CSS, and then I paste it. But what happens immediately, it becomes like this, but that's not what I want. I want it to become this when I scroll down. So what I need to do, I need to go to motion effects and there's effect offset. So if there's an effect, when should it happen? And when you say 0 pixels, that means that if I'm not scrolling, the effect will already be applied. So if I would say 300 pixels, look what happens. Right now it looks like that. When I scroll 300 pixels, all of a sudden, the effect takes place. So after 300 pixels. So what I prefer is something like 20 pixels. So when I'm over here, it will be applied. I like it, but what I don't like is that my menu is gone. So I want to have a different image. And I was searching for this for so long. There are paid themes that can do this. And I was like, with Elementor, why is it not happening? Until I decided to do some research. I'm not a CSS guru, but I know a little bit about CSS. And there's also a CSS trick that I will show you in a minute. Right now, actually. So I click over here. I go to advanced. And at the logo, I give this a CSS class. I call this one static dash logo. Then I hover over here. I duplicate this area. I click on the second logo. I choose an image, and this time I choose the colored logo. And that colored logo should appear when the header is sticky. So when I'm scrolling, it should appear. So over here, I go to advanced and I call this one sticky logo. Well, nothing happens because we need to add CSS code. Again, we can do that over here in the section at advanced, at custom CSS here below. Enter, enter. We can go to the website again, and here it says different logo for the sticky header. So what I say, I call the logos static logo and sticky logo. Here it says sticky logo display is none. So by default, the sticky logo, the colored logo is not shown. But again, when we start scrolling and we have the sticky header, then the sticky logo should appear and the static logo, the white one, should disappear. That's what we are doing with this code. So I copy this code. I paste it here below. I update it. And now, ladies and gentlemen, wow, look at this. This is what happens. I love it. I'm really happy that I found out how this works. And I want to share this with you. That's where this channel is all about. A good moment to ask you if you want to know more about Elementor, WordPress, these tips and tricks, please feel free to subscribe. I am after subscribers. I'm after you. I want all my viewers to become subscribers and add more value, grow my channel, have more fun, and enjoy the process. So if you want to, please do that. And if you want to like this video, you're also free to do that. So it will be watched by more people and the rest of the world will make better websites. We'll all have a good time. So sometimes I get distracted. I remembered I was. What can we also do? We can also create a new area. So I click on the plus over here. I create one new section with two columns again. So right now the section is selected and I want to go to the style, go to the background, a gradient, change the first color to the primary one and the second one to the secondary. And it looks a little bit weird. It's below each other. So we're going to fix it. I want to change the angle to 90. And I'm not sure if it works. I can work like this. I will show you in a minute with the navigator. I can do this, but I rather have that I can see this area. So what I can do, I can update it. Take a look over here. Nothing happens. I edit it with Elementor. And there it is. So that's what you need to do in order to make this appear. And what I can do now, I can drag this area over here. Then I need to change a few things. First, I click over here. I go to advanced. I scroll down. I go to responsive. And I want to show this on every device. I do not want to hide it. Then I go to the column settings over here. I bring this to 50 again, or let's say 30. And I bring this to 0. And I bring the vertical alignment to middle. The horizontal one to the end. Okay, and then I want to have another area, simple text over here, and I will say call us. And there's a number. I don't know exactly what number you have, but I will just make up a number. You can call it to see if it's a real number or not, but I rather would not do that. So then I go to the style. I change the color to white. Bring this to the left and then I update it to see how it will look. Wait a minute, click on the eye, preview, we don't need this anymore. And what I see is there's a lot of space over here and this is not in the center. So how can I fix it? Well, it's also a little bit trial and error. I want to go to the section settings to advanced. I want to have zero margin at the top and zero padding. So let's see what happens. Not much. Then I go to the column settings, advanced, and bring everything to 0. I can also uncheck this and uncheck this. So you see now it's over there. I want to do the same over here. Select it, advanced, uncheck, uncheck, update. So now it's a little bit smaller, the area. And again, I want to bring this to the center, but somehow this text, let me see our vertical alignment middle. It does not do that much. So I click over here. What I can do now, I can go to advanced. I want to bring this to the center vertically. I uncheck this. At the top, I say, bring it a little bit lower, but then the whole area becomes bigger. So I can also say at the bottom, I want to have a minus area, minus margin. So it in that way, I can bring it to the center like that. What I also see is that over here at the left, there's this is the line, but it's not aligning with the logo. And also here at the right, there's much space over here. So how can I align those two? I can do it also, I can do it or over here. Or I can do it over here. So I click on the social icon area and then at the right, I increase it a bit until it's aligned perfectly. Same over here, advanced at the left, increase it until it's aligned. Okay, then we need to see how it looks on a tablet. So far, so good. And on the mobile, okay, so far, not so good. So over here, I click on the column settings. And I don't know about you, I really enjoy this. I like this. So I hope you also like it. It's trial and error, you know, sometimes I'm trying this and then I see, okay, it's not fitting that well. So maybe I should, let me see, increase this area to 60, bring this back to 40. Okay, then over here, I want to go to the style, change the spacing closer to each other to 0. So in that way, we can manage it. So what we'll see, this area does not stick with us. I did not tell it to stick, but this area is, and the logo changes to color. We have this area and then here are social icons. What I want to do now, I want to get rid of the area below this reference area section. So I click on the navigator. And again, don't be afraid for something like this. It's just in the editing area. I want to go to the lowest section, this one, right mouse click, delete. Awesome. Now I want to go to this section and I want to make the website fully transparent or the background. So I go to the style, the color, and I want to drag this all the way to the left. So right now you don't see it. Also here you don't see it. But if I would go to the homepage, clicking on the logo, maybe this is not a good example because there's no content over here. But if I go to the about page, it looks like this. And when I scroll down, it looks like that. But if I go to the blog page, it looks like this. That looks weird. So what I want to do now, I want to take it one step further. So about, it looks great. Contact also looks weird. So I need to change a few things. Oh, by the way, if you see this contact over here, it's really simple. Click on edit with Elementor. And you need to change over here at the settings, change the page layout to Elementor full width. Update, and then the problem is solved. But if I have a white background instead of a colored background, then I rather have a white logo or a white background from the start here at the header. So what I can do, I can go over here. First, I want to go back and exit dashboard. There's something weird going on because right now it has a weird title. So I will call this Elementor Sticky Header Transparent Update. Then I can go to Saved Templates. Or I can go to the theme builder, the new one, of course. And then I see it over here. And when I wait a second, you see my own image. Then I can go to all the headers. And let me see if I can duplicate it. No, but I would like to duplicate it. So what I can do, I can edit this and I can click on the plus and I can save it as a template. So I call this, header sticky transparent, save it. So now it's saved. Where is it? Header sticky transparent. Awesome. So what I want to do now, go back, exit to the dashboard. I want to go to the theme builder, to the new one. I want to add a new area. It is a header. I want to use a template, my template, and I say, are you header sticky transparent? So I get exactly the same thing. But this time, I do not want to make use of all the CSS. So I click over here. I go to advanced CSS, remove all this stuff. I don't need it. Then I want to use this colored logo. I don't want to give this a class anymore. Sticky logo, no. Then I go to the second logo. If I would scroll down, I would see it. Let me see. If I cannot select it, I go to the navigator section. Nope, this section. First image, the white image. I don't need the white image. So I delete it. And the other image, I don't want to have a class. So there it is. Here I select the main menu. Let me see. If I would publish it, what I can do now, I can add conditions. And I can say show it on a certain page. For instance, let me see, pages, the blog page. Save and close. Okay, awesome. What I want to do now, I click over here. I don't know why I do not see it, but I want to change the colors. The text color, I want to bring it to the global color text. And over here again, let me see if the logo is fully visible. No, not yet. I want to make it white and visible. Like that. Let's close for a second because not everything is loading correctly. So I click on the plus or I go back to the dashboard and I call this one Elementor header visible or sticky, but not transparent. So I add it again with Elementor. I hope this time everything will load correctly. Yes, that's what we need. So let's take a look at the example. Yeah. When I hover over something, I want it to become blue. So I grab the global color. And when I'm active, I also want it to become blue. Update, see the result. So what I want to do everywhere where I have a normal white area or a light area, I want to have the visible area, this one, this header. And everywhere there is a color background, for instance, at about, I want to have the transparent area. So how can I do that? I go back to the dashboard. I go to the theme builder, try the new one. Then I need to take a look at the two green ones. This is the template we have saved. This is the visible one. Then I need to go to the one that is transparent. I click on it. I click on edit. And then over here, I can display the conditions. So not the entire site anymore. No, I can say the entire site, except I can say exclude archives, all archives, or I can say a certain archive. Well, I know the blog page is an archive. So right now you see this, if I refresh it, you see nothing. So now there's no header attached to this area. So I can go back to the dashboard, to the theme builder. Oh, by the way, you can also go from within Elementor to the theme builder by clicking here and then going to the theme builder. And then I can select the header with the visible. Now I can select the visible header and edit it. And then over here, click on display conditions. I need to remove this, but I need to see it as an archive. So I go to include archives, all archives. And now if I refresh it, oh, look at this. So I go to the about page that has the transparent header. If I scroll down, it looks like that. But if I go to the blog page, which is an archive, it looks like that. Well, if I go to the contact page, I see the transparent header again. If I go to the services page, it looks like this. So that's what you can do. You can have this beautiful top area over here and the transparent menu, which will display the background of your website. And if you scroll down, it becomes a colored logo with the menu over here. And this area stays on top. And depending on the page where you are with the conditions, you can say what kind of header you want to show. So what you can do now, if you make websites for clients or maybe more websites for yourself, you can export this complete header and import it into a different Elementor Pro website. How can you do that? You go to Elementor and you can select Elementor sticky header. So now I need to go over here, click on this arrow up, save as a template. I say Elementor Pro header sticky and transparent. Save it. But saving is not enough. Let me see. Sticky transparent. I click over here and I click on export. So here I have my JSON file. So you can create a folder in your website with all these JSON files, with all these templates. So I can say Elementor Pro header sticky transparent. And then I know what I mean. So I bring this to the desktop. Then I go to a new website, which has Elementor Pro. I can go to the back end. I go to, let me see, templates, theme builder. Try the new one again. There I go. I want to add a header. But this time from my templates. I click on upload over here on this icon. And I can drag it over here, or I can select a file, go to my desktop, and there it is. Look at this. Open, and I insert it, and there it is. And you see it's using the global colors. So these are other colors. And what I can do now, let me see. Over here I see my logos. I can go to the navigator, to this section, the left column. The first image is the white one. I can change it. I have another one over here. And then the second one image is the colored one. Insert, publish. I want to show this on the entire website. Save and close. I want to take a look, preview. Then I click on the homepage. And there it is. That's how it works. Now you can use it on so many different websites. Of course, you need to change the links and stuff. And you see it is a different menu. And that's how you can do this. And talking about those colors over here, if you go to Elementor, I like to use primary colors. How do you say the global colors? So I go over here, site settings. Hey jongen, ben je helemaal naar boven gekomen? That's my son. He's getting two. Global colors. If I change it over here, it will be changed everywhere in the website where I use global colors. So that's what you can do. Update it. And then let's take a look. Go to the homepage. That's the way the cookie crumbles. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned a ton of stuff, and I did by creating this tutorial, by learning how things work. And I hope you liked the video, and if you do so, please like it. Feel free to subscribe for more upcoming videos. Good luck with your web design business or with your project or whatever what you're doing. And then I hope you have a great day every day for the rest of your life from now on. Bye bye.